So, would everybody stand and
far as announcements, you know, we do our birthdays on the first Sunday of the month, so we have two birthdays to celebrate. One is we two days behind for Brother Leo Dotson. That you were still here with us to continue to celebrate. So God bless you with many more. Yeah. We have another birthday coming up. I don't have a card because unfortunately, of course, he's not here with us anymore. So a happy heavenly birthday to our assistant pastor, Reverend Wiley. We know he is smiling down on us, watching over us, and we are so grateful for everything, the time that we have with him, the lessons that he taught, the love that he gave. So happy heavenly birthday to you, Reverend Wiley. I do see here that it looks like we have some visitors. Would any of our visitors like to say anything or have anything to say?
My name is just Nathan, and I'm from Minnesota, and I'm down in Las Vegas for work, and my lovely girlfriend invited me here, and I'm just glad to be here, and thank you for the service.
Well, thank you guys so much. Thank you for coming. Thank you for extending that invitation out to him. Thank you to our other visitor for coming and joining us. Of a church home in the Las Vegas, how the surrounding areas or somewhere where they can visit, even if you want to be a frequent visitor and check it out until you decide, you know, you're ready, you are more than welcome here. I always say we are small in numbers, but we are mighty with the Lord.
Amen.
And in the words of our assistant pastor,
welcome to love.
With that being said, just please keep me updating you guys so I can make sure the prayer and briefing list is updated as efficiently as possible. Please continue to pray for our pastor and family. Please continue to pray for our assistant pastor's family, the Wiley family. Please continue to pray for Brother Leo Dotson, Christopher Smith, Eric Smith, Courtney Wormwood, Mike Fisher, Ogre Ortiz, Kanan Williams, Willie Ely, the Wilson and Lewis family. Please pray for the Joneses. Please pray for Robert Carter, Ava Jones, Lawrence Pugh, Zinda Young, Terry Walker. Please continue to pray for our church, the members that you see here, the members that you don't see here. Pray for yourselves, whatever you may be battling, whatever you may be going through. All it takes is the faith of a mustard seed. Please continue to pray for our city, our state, our country, and our world. With that being said, I'll get you over to our pastor, Reverend Carl M. Snowden.
Have the church say amen.
Amen.
Again, happy day.
Yes,
it's a happy day that we can come to the house of the Lord. It's a happy day when we can get up and move on our own. It's a happy day when we see our worries, our problems, our situation get dissolved because we know the Lord.
Amen.
God is a blessing. God is great all the time. He's there for you, whether you know it or not. He haven't went nowhere. He's right there. If you trust him, if you call him, if you just accept his son in your life, how beautiful, how blessed you should be.
Yes, Lord.
Talking to my daughter the other day, but you know, in September will be our 9th anniversary. So before we start planning, I wanted to know how many want to go back to the
Golden
Crown. Golden Crown.
Golden Corral.
Golden Corral. I'm sure hands who won't go back to Golden Corral.
Well, this group.
Yes, lost out. But he wasn't even down there last year. You put your hand up against it. You put your hand on doing that. We started working on that and working on what our theme will be and everything. So, but I pray that everybody's doing well today. Whatever problems or whatever things that happen, circumstances in your life, I pray that God is removing them. And God, you can see him through your situation. With that, I'm going to pray. Oh, Father God, as we come to you, morning, Father, as you allowed us to see a new day that we haven't seen before, Father, we thank you for being able to be of use to our limbs and being able to come and just listen to your word, being able to be in the midst of other believers, Father. We thank you for us sharing and having this time together on your behalf, Father. Help us to praise you, worship you, Father. We pray for those that came in the first time, Father, that they be filled, that joy you can bring and a peace of mind that you can give, Father, because each and every one here going through some kind of circumstances or some problem or situation, Father, we're lifting them up to you, Father, because you have the eraser to erase them all, Father, and we thank you for that. We thank you for your son, Jesus Christ, who died over 2,000 years to give us the opportunity to come to you, Father. We pray for those that don't know how to pray. We pray for those that out and about. We pray for those that are out and not here today and don't want to be here or on vacation or going through some things and circumstances and problems. We pray for this world. We pray for all the churches, all the Christians that open in your name, Father. We pray that you can change things and whatever you don't change, but give us the power and the might and the mindset to go through, Father. We ask you these things and all things. In Son of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Father God, we come, we lift this offering up to you, Father. We ask you to be able to bless the money, bless the people that have to give, bless those that don't have to give, because they're here, Father. They're here looking to have a relationship, to have a difference in their lives, Father. Right now, financially, they might be down, but if they just keep it up and believing and having hope, you will change the difference and change their lifestyle and let them understand the thing that you can provide for them and give them, Father. And we thank you, Father, for who you are. We thank you for how you're blessing this church. We might be small, but we're still great in your heart and your mind, Father. You're still smiling on us, Father, and we thank you for this. We thank you for everybody in the sound of my voice today, Father. And we ask you to touch them and deliver them and let them be able to see you through all. In your son's name, Jesus Christ, we pray, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. In the hands of the musicians and the earth.
He's always everlasting.
Thank you.
Israel, why my ways are hidden from the Lord, My cause is disregarded by my God. Do you know? Have you not heard? The Lord is everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. He gives us strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youth grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like an eagle. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. If you could, I'd like to use the subject, focus like an eagle. Turn around to your guests and say, focus like an eagle. Focus like an eagle. Cheetah Mans talks about the eagle's attitude. He said, the eagle flies high and it alone. It flies into challenges. Do you fly high? Do you fly alone? Do you fly into challenges? Do you run from challenges? Sometimes things discourage you, that your health bother you, that you have to walk away from something. Sometimes you can't handle something, but sometimes we just need to stop and talk to the Lord and ask him to strengthen us. Let us fly like an eagle. Let us walk in the ways of the Lord. It said, in the opening scripture says, do you complain, Jacob? Why do you say, Israel, my wage is hidden from the Lord? My cause is disregarded by the word. In other words, he's saying, why do you complain? Why do you say, Israel, my ways is hidden from the Lord? That the things you do that the Lord can't see or the Lord don't know. There's nothing we can hide from God. There's nothing up under the sun that we can do that haven't been done before. My cause discouraged my God. Sometimes we think the things we're doing is wrong or this or that and discourage God, but God sometimes allows you to do things that you can realize that you need him, that you're not strengthened by yourself, but you walk by his grace and his mercy. Do you know, have you heard, the Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the end of the earth? He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. In other words, God don't get tired. We get tired. We go weary. And sometimes we think we can understand God, and we think we got him boxed up in a corner, and he come out with all kind of left, right, and jab. And he just shows you that he got more move than Carter got to appeal. He can do more things than an octopus could. An octopus got so many arms and legs to do things. We can't imagine what God can do and won't do. Then he gives you strength to weak word. He gives you strength to the word. Increases the power of the weak. When you figure you can't go no more, and you call Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord.
He gives you strength. He takes weariness out of you.
Amen.
Do you know? We need the strength of an eagle, the attitude of an eagle. And even young grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. You know, I've been talking to my grandson back there, he was over to the house, and I tell him, sometimes your papa is old now, man. He get tired. Well, y'all be young and strong like me. But he don't think about them times when Mama, I'm tired. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. See, sometimes we older people have to teach the younger people that you got to respect. This journey that we done went through, you coming through. Amen. The thing that one time when I could get up and stand up and do things and hop over fences, which now I see a fence, I go around. You know, this is a tough journey for us. Then, but for those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. In the Lord, you can renew your strength. You hope. They will soar on wings like an eagle. They will run and grow weary. They will walk and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. This is what the Lord offers you. He gives you strength. He can keep you from getting weak. He had you to have an attitude of an eagle. He had you to focus like an eagle. I was reading a book the last night and talking about this church. The preacher got up and preached, and he said, you know, this church needs to learn how to walk. And the deacon got up and said, amen. He must have been Deacon Bob or one of them, or whoever say that. Then he said, you know, this church need to learn how to run. And the deacon got up and said, amen. Yeah. Then he said, this church need to know how to fly. And the deacon got up and said, amen, hallelujah, hallelujah. And then they said, the pastor said, this church need to know how to do things because it costs money. And the deacon said, this church need to learn how to walk. Let's walk. And it won't be even more. But eagle flies alone. They're minding their own business. They said, an eagle, when it's so far up and it's flying, and it might be focusing on something to eat that's so far down. Now, he's looking for something to eat. He ain't looking for nobody cobbler or nobody shoe shine or nobody else. He's looking for something to eat. And he focuses on that. He's not minding other folks' business. The eagle don't look back to see what he had yesterday. He's looking for what he has today. Sometimes we look back for what we had yesterday. But what we had yesterday, if it ain't leftovers, it ain't going to do us no good today. We need to focus on today. The eagle, he loves the storm. They don't run from the problem. Our eagle is not going to run from a fight. Our eagle not going to run from tough situations. He's going to either fly over it or he's going to fly in it. It said when other birds, when the rainstorm and different things are going on, that eagle is still there looking. He's looking for his prey. He's looking for what he can devour and kill. See, we never devour and kill somebody that got more than us. But the eagle is trying to do just enough for survival. Then it said, eagle had excellent vision. Focus when they are going and what they are going and what they're doing. Eagle, he's looking and he's focusing on where he's going, where he needs to be, what he's doing. See, we need to focus on God. We need to focus on God that let us know what we need to do, what we're doing, how we should do it. Sometimes we take matters into our own hands. When we take matters into our own hands and we mess up, what we do then? Oh God, I made a mistake. Oh God, I need you to help me do this. And I guess God sit back and say, you ain't telling me nothing I don't already know. We need to focus on God. We need to look at God. We need to get the strength that God gives us. Don't keep looking back, but look ahead. Whatever you did last year, if it didn't help you this year, why look at it? We need to go straight ahead. Eagle, fresh, pray daily. Don't live in the past. Take on new challenges. Like I say, we can't continue living. Oh, wow, whoa, woe's me. See, when we find this scripture opening up, it said, woe's me. God, I have problems. I have situations. I have circumstances. Where are you, God? Do you care for me? In other words, this is what he said. But we got to stand on the Lord. We got to stand on God. We got to focus on God. We got to look at what God can open up, what God shows through his eyes and not our eyes. See, when we start using our eyes to see our problems and work them out, we fall down. And God keep picking us up. We just like Humpty Dumpty. We fall off the wall and God have to put us back together again.
Yes, Lord.
And sometimes when we put back together again, it might not be like we was before. If you let God put you back together, you have peace of mind. You have joy. You can have happiness. And you can be one of God's children. Then we talk about eagles are committed to do what it takes to live and grow. They're committed. See, when an eagle's youngins are young, that mama eagle trains them. They push out of that nest to learn how to fly and get strong. See, God has given us a church to come to learn how to fly, learn how to walk, learn how to run, and get strength. God has blessed us. He said, on this rock, I'll build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail. He didn't say, on this rock, I'll build a denomination. He said, his church, to follow after him. But man, and mingle like they do anything else. They mingle and try to mess up something good. You know, it's just like you making a potato pie. Well, you know this is a good potato pie, but it needs a little more of this, a little more thing. In life, we act like we making a potato pie. We need a little more of this. We need a little more of that. We need to do this or do that. But we have to be committed to what the Bible says, the ways of the Lord. We have to practice what God has given us to practice in. We have to use the talent that God has given us. Each and every one in here has a talent. Each and every one in here, God has given you something that you can use in the church to grow. You to grow yourself. You to have a relationship. Eagles train hard. They train hard. Like I said, they come out the nest flying and building up and watching and looking. But an eagle fly alone. Have you ever seen a bunch of eagles together? When you see them out in the wilderness, you always see that one by soaring all over, flying around. Sometimes eagles are hard to find because they're minding their own business. I guess they're flying pack so they can talk about, oh, your wing tip, are you this color, are you this or that? They fly alone. But do we fly alone? Do we pray? Do we fast? Do we have quiet times? Do we talk to the Lord? Are we working hard? Or will we just sit back? See, people tell you, wait on the Lord. He'll take care of it. Yeah, he will take care of it. But the Lord wants you to build a relationship through the things that I just mentioned. He don't want you just to sit in the rocking chair and say, oh God, you got it. He wants you to learn to have hope, learn to have faith, learn to have trust, learn to have belief. We need an attitude of a believer. We need to learn how to focus. To focus on the Lord. To focus on God. To focus on the thing that he has us to do. And quit turning around, my head ache, my legs, I'm tired, I'm sick of this or that. But the same one you talk about you all these problems with is the one that can change the circumstance. If you do something for him. If you talk to him. If you get closer to him. If you trust him. In closing, don't let no one kill your focus. Don't let no one kill your eyesight on the Lord. Don't let no one kill your relationship with God. No one let no one. See, sometimes when you're praying or doing a morning devotion, or when you're spending quiet time with the Lord, that's why they tell you to go in a closet. And leave your phone there. Leave your water there. Leave anything there that will disturb you with that time with the Lord. Let him know how you love him. Let him know how you want to be intimate with him. Let him know how he's done for you. And just talk to him. And he will bless you.
Amen.
Spend time with him. Tell him about your pains and your aches, your heartbreaks, your finance, your discouragement. Spend time with him alone. Be like an eagle. Spend time with him alone. Focus on him. The doors of the church are open. Amen. Himself. So when So then, whenever eats the bread or drink the cup of the Lord is unworthy manner, will be guilty of sin against the body and blood of the Lord. In other words, the sin, people don't understand and really been taught that the Lord's Supper is a reunion, is a respect, is the communication with Him. And they just eat it and drink it. See, a long time ago, they used to party. And by the time the people that got there that really knew what it was for, it was all gone. And we take it, I'm unworthy. See, I'm unworthy, you're unworthy, you did this and that. But the Bible said, can't nobody clean us up but Jesus. He can make us white as snow. We can't make ourselves worthy, but through Him, He'll make us worthy. And He made us worthy on the cross. Everyone ought to examine themselves before they eat of this bread and think. Just sit back and ask the Lord, if you did anything wrong, help me. Clean me up. You know, and He got you back. He's not going to run from you. He's not going to laugh at you. He said He'd take on your burdens. He'd be there for you. For those who eat and drink without discerning the body of Christ, eat and drink judgment on themselves, not understanding and discerning and talking to the Lord. So, we're going to do this and go ahead and pray.
Heavenly Father, we want to ask that you give us this day. Give us our daily bread. Father, we ask that you come down and see us and talk to us and just communicate with us, Father. Father, we ask that your communication, it's all that we need to let us know where we come from, where we are, and where we want to go. These things we ask in the Son of Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.